on, everyone? It's Ryan from Dude to Dad here with Dad Hack number 5. So we are in the final stretch. We got anywhere from 2 to 3 weeks left before the new arrival comes home, baby boy Striker. So we are super excited about that, but there's a lot of things that got to get done. So today we're going to focus on tasks to complete before the baby arrives. There's a lot of things to do, from pretty simple to make sure you got some diapers, baby formula, which is a little hard to find right now, and you don't know what the baby likes, and your baby wipes. If I could recommend anything, dad hack wise, when people say, what can we get your kids? Get Target gift cards, get Costco gift cards, diapers, keep the receipts, baby wipes, because anyone out there that's got kids know it could get super expensive with the amount of diapers you go through. So we'll kick it off. I got a few things to do around the house. Be emotionally support to your wife at this time is the biggest thing. Be supportive of anything she wants you to do. And she's got a bunch of tasks for me to do around the house today. So let's get it going.
All right. First thing you got to do to get ready for the big welcome in home is to get the baby clothes washed and ready to go. So up here, you can actually see Dreft. We personally like this. It's made specifically for babies, newborns, stage 1 hypoallergenic, no additives. So it's super safe for the baby. Smells great. A little pricey, but you know, if you go to your local Costco's or BJ's, you'd actually get this in bulk on sale. Make sure everything with baby too, go to the websites. A lot of the websites have coupons that you could redeem to save a couple bucks, because it all adds up. But you know, first and foremost, you got to get the clothes washed and ready to go. So we're using that Dreft before the baby's arrival. As you can see, my beautiful and supportive wife organized this closet. I had absolutely nothing to do with it because she would yell at me. So we had to make sure we washed the clothes, got them dried out there. So another cool thing that she added, the touch, are these little tags. So 0 to 3 months, 3 to 6 months, etc. Down below also, we have containers that we just picked up from Target, 99 cents. And then we have this shelf that we added again from Target, around 40 bucks. So super easy and affordable way to organize the baby closet. Again, the first thing, we got to get the clothes washed, hung up, and ready for that home arrival.
On to another task to do before the baby arrives, and I just got tasked. This beautiful shelf needs to be hung in the corner of the room because we have to hang things off of it. So again, emotional support, I'm here for you. So we're gonna get this hung. I actually just got yelled at because I had my tools on a clean bassinet and a crib with sheets we just washed. So part of me, while I have to reach down to grab all the necessary tools needed. So similar to a couple videos ago, we're just gonna measure from left to right and get the length of this divided by half to get the measurement. So we got 36 and a half measurements. 18.25 is what we want to go for in the middle. So what we're going to do is mark it off. So we got 18.25. Perfect. And what we want to do is just figure out what we want to hang it from. So it's a little bit of a long length. So I'm just going to go off the top of this edge over here. So what I'm going to essentially do is find my mark. I'm going to follow it all the way up to level with this. Mark it off, X, we're good to go. Next thing I'm gonna do, again, use the stud finder. Gonna move around here, see if we're in a stud or if we're on the outside. So we're on the stud, so essentially I'm gonna come over around 1/4 inch and use one of these. This is a monkey hook. If you guys are not familiar with it, check it out. It's a new way to hang mirrors. They can hold anywhere from 45 to 50 pounds all the way down to 10 pounds. Essentially, we're just gonna punch it through the sheetrock, twist it up, and it's gonna level against that and could pretty much hang anything you need to get the project done. So let's get her hung. So after taking those measurements, got her hung up. We're gonna use a small level to make sure we are leveled off. So with that monkey hook, hung it right from the ropes. You can't see it. It looks like we're level. And then to my surprise, I just got another exciting news. My beautiful Tide clock that I purchased for my man cave is getting taken from me and getting placed in the new baby's room. So this is why the wife got the shelf. She decided not to tell me about this piece. So super sweet. Anyone that lives around the ocean, loves the ocean. It's a tide clock, matches up with Atlantic or Pacific. Essentially what it does is lets you know when it's low tide, high tide, and when times are remaining. So now I'm gonna have to creep into the baby's room if I wanna get down to check out the beach. But as a dad, you gotta give everything. So with that, We got her hung up, we got the shelf, and we got the tide clock. So on to the next task. We are getting some tasks knocked off. First, before I jump into this next task, I don't know if any of you guys noticed, I have a plain shirt on. My wife did not like my previous shirts in the videos, said I had to get serious, so this is my serious shirt. Old Navy, $4, huge score. So next task in hand is getting the bottles ready, washed and sanitized. So we're using the Dr. Brown bottles, use these with my first child. Super simple, couple steps in this. These are actually glass, which is something new. We worried about kind of the plastics and all the materials that could harm the baby potentially. So essentially, you're gonna have this little sanitizer. It's got two levels to it. And then what you're gonna do is just take everything apart and you're gonna start stacking them pieces little by little to get everything clean. So we got four bottles here. Gonna add a half a cup of water in that. It takes around 5 minutes, let it sit for another five, get sanitized, ready to go. As a kid develops, starts fresh, these are 2 ounce bottles, are pretty cool. They come with a bottle, pre-mix, shaker up. They got the nipple that goes on top of it also. So these are easy on the go if you're out doing things, run around town. This is another good option for you. So let's get everything sanitized and ready to go. It's been around 20 minutes since I put these in the sanitizer. The light is off and I let it sit for around, 8 to 10 minutes. So we are good to take them out. Super hot, so just be careful when you remove these. Again, just let the lid sit. But yeah, we got our four bottles in there. We got two shorts, two longs, along with all the pieces that go with them. So we are sanitized and ready to go for the baby and the milk. The last task is make sure you have a great route to get to the hospital. We're going to be delivering at Riverview Medical Center. It's around 2 miles away from here, but you got to ensure the time of day you're going to be checking because there could be some obstacles. Recently, Red Bank just closed out Broad Street again, which is causing massive traffic. So what I'm going to do now is hop in the car, set a timer as if we're ready to go, and then we'll go from there. I would take you for a ride, but you can't text and drive. So wish me luck.